Roshni Manglani, and today we are looking into 12th Commerce English Flamingo Unit 2, that is Lost Spring, Stories of Stolen Childhood. So this is the chapter's name, Lost Spring, Stories of Stolen Childhood. Now why Lost Spring? Why is this name? Because spring, here spring is not the spring, your spring is the childhood. It is a season that we enjoy the most, and hence it is the childhood, is the phase of our life that we enjoy the most. So why is it lost? Because here the author, Agnes Jung, has written this story. It is an excerpt, that means it is a taken part from her book, which is titled as Lost Spring, Stories of Stolen Childhood. Here she discusses about the grinding poverty. Matlab, bahut zyada poverty, right? Poverty is poor, right? And traditions, aisi grinding poverty or traditions that helps or leads the children to a life of exploitation. Exploitation, matlab, they cannot do anything by themselves. They are exploited. Right. So this chapter has two stories. We are discussing the first one, that is, sometimes I find a rupee in the garbage. So this is the title of the first story. Here she has discussed two stories. The first one is sometimes I find a rupee in the garbage. Now what do you understand by this? Sometimes, kabhi kabhi I find a rupee. Kabhi kabhi mujhe paise mil jate kahan se? Garbage mein se. Garbage is what? Kooda aur kachra. So now we discuss about the two main characters. These are the only two main characters in the story. The one is the narrator, that is the author herself, and then is Sahib-e-Alam. Alright, Sahib-e-Alam is the child, is the rag picker, that means kuda uthane wala, the one we'll be discussing, the protagonist of the story. Now here it was a morning that the author was just moving around the neighborhood. There she saw rag pickers, right? And then she asked Sahib that, what are you doing? So Sahib answered, searching for gold. Now why gold and where? So he was looking, scrounging in the garbage. He was searching for gold in the garbage. So Sahib is basically from Dhaka, Bangladesh, and they have left Bangladesh. Their generations have left Bangladesh. If you can see here, I have written Bangladesh. These were all from the Bangladeshi refugees. Those have come to India in 1971. So Sahib is one of them. And why they have come from Bangladesh to India? Because they had storms which ruined their fields and homes. So they had no option than to leave Bangladesh. Okay, so their generations have left Bangladesh and come to India in 1971. So their generations have been living in India as Bangladeshi refugees. Now where they live in Simapuri. Simapuri is in the outskirts of Delhi. Now Simapuri is a little less developed area. So what happened, it was this same morning that the author, Anish Jung, asked, like, why don't you go to school to Sahib? Then Sahib said, because I don't have any in my neighborhood. School kyun nahi jaate? Kyunki mere neighborhood mein koi school hi nahi hai. So the author, Anish Jung, promised, like, she was just joking and she just said, so what if I build one? To kya agar main school banau to tum aoge? So Sahib, with many hopes, said, yes, definitely, I will come to the school. So it was again another morning that Sahib came running to the author, asking, so is your school ready? To kya tumhari school ban gayi hai? So then was the point that the author thought. It was this thought stuck in author's mind that I have made such a false promise to him that has created hopes. And to these people like Sahib, these promises are ample. बहुत सारे लोग ऐसे बहुत सारे खोखले promises, false promises करके जाते हैं. ऐसे लोग जो कि साहिब की तरह होते हैं. And then she asked Sahib, the narrator asked Sahib, like, what is your full name? Because she was only knowing Sahib. So she asked, what is your full name? Then he said, it is Sahib-e-Alam. Sahib-e-Alam means law of universe. And at the back of her mind, she is thinking, ki agar is ladke ko apne naam ka matlab pata chal jaye, that my name means Lord of universe, तो उसको कभी ये सारी चीजों पे विश्वास ही नहीं होगा. Why? Because he was running barefoot with the army of, you know, rag pickers. अपने दोस्तों के साथ सारे के सारे रोज सुबह आते हैं कचरा कूड़ा उठाने, and they were barefoot, नंगे पैर, चप्पल्स नहीं पहनते थे वो. और वो लोग इसको कैसे एक्सप्लेन करते थे, हम लोग चप्पल्स क्यों नहीं पहनते, बिकॉज ऑथर आस्क्ड व्हाई डोंट यू वेयर चप्पल्स. तो उनके लिए एक रीजन होता है कि ये तो एक हमारा ट्रेडिशन है. या कोई बोलता है कि मेरी मम्मी ने मेरे चप्पल शेड से नीचे उतार कर नहीं दी. So it was like that tradition that they explained. और यही सारी बातें author सुनकर उसको एक incident आता है यार उड़ीपी से. So उड़ीपी में there was this young boy जिसका father was a priest and then he had a school crossing a temple. So whenever he goes to school there was a temple in between. There he stops by and prays, भगवान प्लीज आई नीड अ पेयर ऑफ शूज, आई एक्चुअली स्पेयर देम, मैं बहुत अच्छे से पहनूंगा, प्लीज प्लीज प्लीज. सो ही वाज, यू नो, क्वाइट ऑफन प्रेइंग एवरी टाइम. सो आफ्टर 30 इयर्स द ऑथर विजिटेड द सेम प्लेस, देयर द कंडीशंस हैव चेंज्ड, देयर एवरीबॉडी एज इन द यंग मेन द चिल्ड्रन, देयर दे हैव शूज टू वेयर. ओके नाउ, बट स्टिल हियर देयर द ऑथर सीज दीज रैग पिकर्स, दे आर स्टिल बेयरफुट. अभी भी यहां पर कंडीशन ज्यादा अच्छी नहीं हुई है. व्हेन शी कंपेयर्स इट विद उदित, दिस वन इंसिडेंट दैट शी रिमाइंड्स. नाउ सीमापुरी इज अ होम टू 10,000 रैग पिकर्स. सीमापुरी ऐसी जगह है जो अभी भी 10,000 रैग पिकर्स को घर की तरह लगती है. नाउ दीज आर अगेन द सेम बांग्लादेशी रेफ्यूजीज जो इंडिया में आए थे अपनी जनरेशन, लाइक 1971 दे केम. नाउ व्हाट डू दे हैव इन सीमापुरी, कैसे रहते हैं वो लोग? उनके पास रूफ्स ऐसे हैं जो टिन और टार्पोलिन के हैं, पत्रे और जो रेनकोट जैसा, देयर इज अ ब्लैक टार्पोलिन, देयर इज अ ब्लैक टार्पोलिन, राइट? सो इट इज नॉट अ प्रॉपर सीमेंटेड रूफ दैट दे हैव विद ब्रिक्स, सो इट इज जस्ट टिन एंड टार्पोलिन दैट द रूफ्स दैट दे हैव. एंड देयर इज नो रनिंग वाटर, देयर इज नो ड्रेनेज फैसिलिटी, नथिंग. And they don't have any identity, but they have ration cards. So to them, ration card is something that is a promise that okay, at least we'll get two meals, right? That is more than sufficient to us, rather than having an identity that brings us nothing, right? So that is the reason that they have left their very good fields and homes in Bangladesh, because there it was actually impossible for them to earn their bread. Now how do they earn their bread? They earn their bread from collecting garbage. Now garbage hamare liye kachra hai, theek hai. Ab unke parents ke liye garbage kya hai? Jo Simapuri ke reh rahe hain un logon ke liye, unke parents ke liye unka earning hai, unka daily bread kamata hua ek occupation hai. बट वही चीज एक बच्चे के लिए क्या है? टू अ चिल्ड्रन इट इज व्हाट? इट इज समथिंग रैप्ड इन वाटर. यू कैन थिंक ऑफ योर बर्थडे, राइट? यू माइट हैव योर बर्थडे, राइट? एवरी ईयर अ डे इज योर बर्थडे. सो व्हेनेवर इट इज लाइक योर बर्थडे पार्टी, यू गेट अ लॉट्स ऑफ गिफ्ट्स एंड देयर इज समथिंग रैप्ड इनसाइड इज अ प्रेजेंट. सो यू थिंक ऑफ इट, इट इज रैप्ड इन वाटर. तो यही चीज इन लोगों के लिए गार्बेज, जो ये छोटे बच्चे लाइक साहिब और उसकी पूरी गैंग असेंबली जो लेकर के घूमता है रैग पिकर्स की, उन लोगों के लिए वो जो कचरा है, इट इज समथिंग रैप्ड इन वंडर. एक ऐसी चीज है जो जिसके अंदर चाहे तो तुम कभी एक रुपए का नोट मिल सकता है, चाहे तो तुमको कभी 10 रुपए मिल सकते हैं, चाहे कभी कोई सिल्वर की भी चीज मिल सकती है. सो इट इज समथिंग रैप्ड इन वंडर. हाउएवर एट द साइड इफ यू टॉक अबाउट देयर एल्डर्स, उनके लिए एक घर पर छत है, दो वक्त की रोटी है, दिस गार्बेज. ओके, so then what happened, it was winter morning and again the author met Sahib. So he was just around the neighborhood club watching some people playing tennis, and he was so fascinated by the game. And then the author, and he's young, noticed that he, Sahib, was wearing tennis shoes. So the author has seen the shoes, and the shoes were discarded, as in कोई किसी रिच बच्चे ने अपने वो शूज डिस्कार्ड कर दिए, मतलब फेंक दिए. क्यों? क्योंकि थोड़ा सा उसमें छेद हो गया हो. अब वो छेद ऑथर के लिए साहिब के लिए वाज नथिंग मच बट इट वाज अ ड्रीम कम ट्रू दैट एटलीस्ट नाउ आई हैव शूज टू वेयर राइट देन व्हाट हैपेंड और वन डे अगेन इन द मॉर्निंग द ऑथर नरेटर दैट इज अनीस जंग saw Sahib. So he was going down to a mill and with a steel canister. Okay. So he was carrying a steel canister and he was going down to a mill. And they had a conversation where the author, the narrator came to know that Sahib now works for a mill booth. Okay. He gets paid 800 rupees and all his meals. So while he was carrying that steel canister, he wasn't having a carefree and a this free look that while he is actually having his garbage bags. So the garbage bags was much more lighter than the steel canister that he is now holding. So the steel canister that he holds is much heavier. Though not literally, but actually the carefree look is being lost from Sahib's face. So now what he has lost here? He is no longer his own master. अब वो खुद का master खुद नहीं है. पहले वो जब चाहता, जैसे चाहता, and he is very happy, you know, with his all the teammates coming together, picking up the garbage, scrounging for something that they mean to be fascinating. However, it is no longer this. He has a routine now. He has to wake up. He has to carry the steel canister. He gets paid 800. However, still he is no longer his own master. So this is the end of part one. Now I want you all to just remember the story. Likewise, that is the reason I have plotted the points here so that you can remember. In the introduction, I want you all to include these things: grinding, poverty, traditions, life of exploitation to children. Okay. Now, what is your homework in the live session and there we meet? I'll solve every doubt that you have regarding this story. I'll also send a PDF of the worksheet that you have to solve. If there is still any query, I'll get back to you in the live session. Okay, thank you.